Hey students, welcome to HR with Sanchita. So today's topic is ASH effect. ASH effect in organizational behavior, or it is very important in psychology, organizational sciences, behavior. So this is what we are going to study today. And yes, it is really important for the people studying management, for the people studying MBA, for UGC NET students also, because anything can come in UGC NET. In every UGC NET, new theories pop up. So you need to know all the theories, the maximum you can know, right? So this is something I always say, subscribe. So subscribe to my channel and yes, like and share it with your friends so that they can get the benefit of it. And yes, also follow my Telegram page, which is really important. So if you want to stay updated that what videos I'm going to put, okay, or what classes I'm going to take, especially for the UGC NET students, I'm taking classes over various platforms, over this YouTube and over an academy also. So you can just stay updated that what will be my schedule, when I would be taking classes. For example, now I'm starting taking classes on an academy for the UGC NET students because the exam is in May. So I'll just start taking free special classes for them. So if you are planning to give UGC NET, then obviously you can come to my Telegram page, HR with Sanchita. The link is pinned in my comments in this video and in almost all my videos, right? The name is HR with Sanchita, and you can go through that link and stay updated related to all my classes. Okay, so now let's see what is ASH effect. So first of all, we should know that who is the propounder or who has conducted these experiments. So these are also known as the ASH experiments in management and the ASH effect. And these experiments were conducted by Solomon E. Ash. So just remember this name because you can be asked the propounders, right? So ASH effect has been given by Solomon E. Ash, and he conducted a series of experiments on group pressure in 1940. So what were these experiments related to? These experiments were related to group pressure. Okay, and they are known as ASH effect or ASH experiments in management. So just take a note of it. So now let's start with this statement. Social pressure can convince group members to falsify their beliefs in response to even mild social pressure. So just let's start with an example. When you were studying in school and the teacher used to ask you a question and you knew the right answer, but most of your classmates were giving a wrong answer, then you must be in a condition of like, you must be thinking that, am I right? Even if you knew the right answer and your classmates were giving a wrong answer, but so many of people are giving a wrong answer, then you must be thinking that, are you right? Are you giving the right answer? Then there must have come a situation when you also must have went along with the group and given a wrong answer because you thought that maximum of them are giving this answer. So maybe I am wrong and this is the answer. So just to confirm with the group, you also gave the wrong answer in spite of knowing the right answer. So this is the ASH effect. See, the ASH effect is the phenomenon of group consensus and social pressure that influences an individual to change the correct answer in reaction to group members. So you, what you did is you knew the right answer, but you changed it, changed the correct answer. And why you changed the correct answer? Because your classmates were giving, most of your classmates were giving that wrong answer. Okay, so you thought that, let's go with that wrong answer only because most of your classmates are giving it. So, influences the individual to change a correct answer in reaction to group members' incorrect answer to the same question. Social pressure can convince group members to falsify their beliefs. So, what did you do? What did you do with yourself? You falsified your beliefs, okay, due to social pressure, right? So, this is the ASH effect. So now let's see what is the intake for the managers or what is the lesson for the managers due to this ASH effect. So a manager should know that this kind of phenomena can occur. ASH effect occurs in an organization. So if it can occur with you people, then obviously in the organizations also teams are there, people are working in groups. So ASH effect can occur there also. So the managers also should learn a lesson and know this effect that these things can happen. So what is the intake for the managers? The ASH effect illustrates that the employees may change their beliefs in response to group pressure for achieving consensus. So in order to come to a consensus, the employees may change their beliefs in line with the group members, right? So what it highlights for the managers. So the manager should avoid accepting group decisions without first exploring the process. Okay, so for example, if a manager has told the group that you need to give this decision related to a new process that we are planning to establish in our company, so give your decision whether we should go with this process or whether we should not go with this process. So the manager gets a decision after 2-3 days that yes, we should go with the new process. Okay, so When the manager receives the group decision that yes, you should go with the process, the manager should see that what is the process that they adopted or adapted for this group decision making, for taking this decision, what process the group members adapted. Okay. So the manager must ensure that different opinions are considered. For example, if there are 6 members in that team, are the opinions of all the 6 members considered? Okay. Are the individual or independent opinions of those 6 members considered? It should not be the case that 4 members of the group agreed, yes, the new process should come, and 2 did not agree, but that the maximum 4 people were agreeing. So the 2 also said, chalo, let's go with that decision. And internally, they are not happy with it. Okay, internally, they did not want that new process to come. But the 4 members of the team were agreeing that yes, they want the new process. So they also agreed. So the manager should see that all the opinions are considered. Okay, and what was the process for bringing out this decision? Right. So this is the intake and lesson for managers. Okay, so thank you, and yes, like, share and subscribe to my channel and follow my Telegram page, and see you on Unacademy.